All right, folks, so Reaganomics under attack, philosophically, politically, whatever it is in the UK. We know here in America, though, Bidenomics shaping up to be a crushing 1-2 punch for Americans, right? First, you have inflation, which won't go away, and now potentially deep recession. Lili Gil Valletta is with me now. And, you know, there's a new Lily, there's a new Gallup poll I saw this morning first thing, and it really blew me away in a sense that there's been a surge in Americans' preference for Republicans when it comes to prosperity. Do you think people were sort of forego now the promise of more free stuff, the politics of envy, and start to focus on prosperity for themselves?
I think after 2 years, it's finally sinking in for Americans that when your gas prices go up, your food goes up, and you're not earning as much, wait a second, what's wrong with this formula? And it may be policies that we continue to see aggravating this over and over again. So I believe strongly people will be voting with their wallets, and November is going to be very telling for what will happen from now until 2024 for sure.
You know, one thing that I know the Democrats have done a lot is try to separate the stock market from the economy, unless it's doing really well. But we have more people invested in this market than ever before. Could there be a sense out there, at least from your point of view, that maybe people will understand that the war against the stock market is a war against Main Street, and why not be an investor in the greatest country in the world?
That's right. And you know, technology is accessible to everybody. After COVID, the uptake of fintechs, that like the Acorns and Robin Hoods of the world, is up 73%. And millennials, which now are a bigger population than boomers, want to enter into the economy, want to participate in that. And it's no longer this like complicated thing. I got to call a special broker somewhere. You can just do it on your phone. And yes, why not participate in this great nation with all these companies that are American born and making money even in the midst of a recession? So I want to bet on growth.
You know what I love too is that they're using things like Reddit. They're using things like the internet. The stuff I see people post on Twitter, some of the due diligence is so impressive.
It is.
Even more impressive than Wall Street. The same Gallup poll showed Republicans pulling ahead in general, overall favorability, and starting to really pull out by a pretty good margin. Is this about quality of life in this country beyond prosperity and economics, but crime and things like that?
Yeah, well, you know that we do big data analytics, and our last read as of today for the last 30 days based on 6 million data points continues to put the economy and crime as the top issues for all Americans. We even look by ethnicity, different groups, equally for everybody. That's what we want. Live a good life, earn a good living, and yes, feel safe when you're walking around and enjoying the neighborhood that you live in. So that will be the measure and what the current politics or policies will be evaluated as.
You know, it's interesting because, listen, I lived in New York City in Harlem in the 70s, right? And even though people, it's bad now, it was a gazillion times worse then.
There just weren't
any camera phones to capture all of it. But I saw the carnage. Why all of a sudden, though, do you have these traditional Democrat voting blocks who are saying, hey, enough is enough? What's been the tipping point?
I think, and sadly, but the data shows it, there's no longer this black cloud that goes over being a Republican equal supporting, you know, our former President Trump, which was somewhat controversial. But forget about personalities. People are looking now at policies.
And but I even think before Trump, there were people who, I'm always going to vote Democrat, even though I live in a crime-infested city,
even though
I can't get a job, even though my kids are getting a bum education, I'm going to keep voting Democrats. Something's waking up. I mean, you see what's happening with Latinos. You know.
Exactly.
You did it. I mean, and then you see with black voters. What is there something? Is it just finally the time has come?
I think, you know, I had never seen such a low favorability for President Biden amongst Hispanics. We saw 60% as of last week, negative and neutral towards him. So I think it's the fact that we can now see what happens in states like Florida, or now I live in Texas, right, versus New York.
Right.
And in the pandemic where everything was aggravated, you could see that very big difference between kids that couldn't go to school here while they were open and thriving in places like Texas and Florida.
Yeah, we already had achievement gaps in these cities like New York
and
D.C.
It's getting worse.
Yeah, 2 years, 3 years, maybe 4 or 5 years now. I mean, these are people who are going to be wedded to welfare programs because they'll never have the education to achieve.
That's exactly
Lily,
right.
Lily, thank you so much. Appreciate you.
Thank you.
All right, folks, coming up.